Welcome all my friends and students. Today I am going to teach you a new dish by the name of paneer lababdar. So here are the spices. We'll not waste any time. I'll start fast to introduce you to some of the ingredients which we will use. Again, a lot of spices you can see here. Degi mirch powder, whole black pepper, yellow chili powder. So this is yellow chili powder. You can see here. Salt, melon seeds, kasuri methi, cinnamon, green cardamom, cashew nuts, whole red chilies which are dried, cloves and bay leaf. So these are the spices which we are going to use. Apart from this, I am going to show you a special ingredient which I am using. This is Shahi Jeera. Okay, you can see it is thin as compared to the regular Jeera and black in color. So I will show you a regular Jeera also over here. See, this is a regular Jeera and this is Shahi Jeera. So you can see the difference in both of them. This is mostly used in Mughlai preparations. So we are going to prepare a Mughlai gravy, that is lababdar gravy. So I am going to use this jeera in that. For the herbs, I am going to use ginger garlic, you can see here, and green chili which I have chopped up, some green coriander which I will use for garnishing, and some capsicum. I will tell you how to use this after the preparation of the gravy. Then I have already diced the cheese. You can see here cottage cheese paneer has been diced. And then for the gravy, two major ingredients of the gravy are tomatoes, ripe red tomatoes, sweet tomatoes, around 750 grams, and onion which is 500 grams. And we are going to use refined oil. So this is refined soybean oil. You can use rice bran oil also for making this. So let us start. So here I have taken a pan, I have heated this pan, you can see a clean pan over here. I have put some oil in this. You see, I have put in the soybean oil, refined soybean oil. Then next I am going to put some spices in this. This is green cardamom, cinnamon, bay leaf. I am putting everything in front of you so you can judge the quantity which I am using. Cloves, one dried red chili, then I am going to use Shahi Jeera, next I will put this ginger garlic which I have chopped up. Coming out of the spices and ginger garlic mixture. Stir it a little bit. Next, I will put this sliced onion. For few minutes. So basically we are going to soften this onion, make it soft, not to turn it brown. So we leave it on slow flame for 2 to 3 minutes and it will become soft. So till the time our onion is softening, I will show you. I have taken hot water in this pot and I am going to put melon seeds and cashew nuts in this hot water so that they also soften up till the time onion is getting soft. I have put them in hot water, let them soft, become soft for 10 to 15 minutes. Then I am going to show you how to use them. So now the onion has become soft, you can see here. Onion has become soft. Now when the onion has become soft, next step is addition of spices. So for that, I am going to put coriander powder. You can see here coriander powder. Some turmeric powder. Now special yellow chili powder. because this gravy is yellowish in color, hence yellow chili powder. And then I am going to put tomatoes. So now again leave it on slow flame for 10 to 15 minutes till tomatoes also become soft. After 5 minutes I am going to put some salt. You can see I am putting salt. This is to soften the onion and tomatoes. And then I am going to put some degi mirch powder. Then you can use some hot water, boiling hot water. I put in some boiling hot water in this, basically so that the masalas do not burn and they mix well with onion and tomatoes. This is a very delicious gravy. Once it is prepared, you can see a beautiful yellowish orange color of this gravy and delicious flavor. Next, I am going to close it for next 7 to 8 minutes with a lid and let it cook. So now you can see after 15 minutes the gravy is really cooked up, onions and tomatoes have cooked up, and then I will remove these whole masalas, bay leaf, chili, I will remove this cinnamon, okay, and then next what I will do is I will add these soaked up cashew and melon seeds into this mixture. First switch off the gas. See, I have switched off the gas. Then I will take out this mixture and I will put these seeds in this mixture and blend it into a puree. So you see here I have removed the water, drained off the water, and I will put this melon seeds and cashew seeds in this mixture. Okay, now next I will make it into a puree. So now you see this mixture has become cold. I am putting it in the blender for blending it. This has become cold and now I am going to blend it. So this is the pureed mixture. You can see beautiful yellow color. So now I am going to tell you how to go further about preparing this gravy. So now you can see I am starting with preparation of the gravy. I have taken 50 grams of butter in this pan. All Mughlai gravies are really rich gravies, so they are tempered in butter. So the best quality butter should be used. You can use Amul butter or even you can use white butter prepared at home. Once the butter is melted on a slow flame, I am going to put some kasuri methi. Then once again some yellow chili powder, one whole red chili, once again some shahi jeera, because shahi jeera and yellow chili powder make up the flavor of this lababdar gravy. They are the two most important ingredients in this recipe, shahi jeera and yellow chili powder. Then next, I will put this puree. So, I am going to put this puree for 15 minutes till it mixes completely and gets cooked well. So we wait for 10 to 15 minutes on a slow flame. You can even cover it because the gravy will splutter out as it cooks. Now I will show you how to temper the capsicum, which we are going to use finally for adding a new dimension of flavor in this gravy. So I have taken some oil. Again putting some chai jeera. Beautiful smell. then adding the beautiful flavor coming out from the capsicum. This will give a new dimension of the flavor to the recipe. Little bit of yellow chili powder again, and this is cottage cheese which I have marinated with salt, yellow chili powder and little bit of baby milk powder. Some people add the cheese just like that also, but I prefer adding it like this because it will give a new flavor to the gravy. And your paneer pieces are also coated with shahi jeera and yellow chili powder, you can see here. You can even serve it as a snack item. So it's ready. Now I have my gravy over here. This is also ready. In this gravy, I am going to add this paneer and capsicum mixture. Again, it will splutter because it has thickened. Mix it well. Next, add the cream. So, this is Amul cream which I have added. Beautiful yellow color and aroma of yellow chili powder, extra flavor of capsicum. Delicious recipe, original recipe of 5-star hotels, which you can easily prepare at your home also. So here the dish is ready. Now finally I am going to present it and show you how to garnish it. So here you see beautiful presented paneer labab dar. Now I am garnishing with some cream on the top and fresh coriander chopped, green chili and whole red chili. Hope you enjoyed this recipe and you will definitely try this at your home. Do share it with your friends, family and relatives. Thank you so much for watching.